Peierls and I back in 1934 said that the only way one could observe a neutrino is if you capture it again in a nucleus. Well, that's correct, and that was actually observed after the war when very powerful nuclear reactors were built, which emit tremendous densities of neutrinos. Fred Reines and Cowan observed the neutrinos emanating from the Savannah River nuclear reactor. So that showed that neutrinos can be observed. And then in the last 10 or 20 years, when we had high energy accelerators, much higher energy neutrinos were formed, and neutrinos were observed in, for instance, in Fermi lab or in CERN in Europe, coming out of these very high energy accelerators. But once neutrinos had been observed, it was a nice, interesting idea that maybe you could observe the neutrinos which are made in the sun. I mentioned the proton-proton reaction. You make a deuteron and a positron, and with the positron comes a neutrino, and that reaction is then followed by a lot of others. You make beryllium-7, which captures an electron and again emits a neutrino. Once in a blue moon, the beryllium-7 gets further enhanced and becomes boron-8, which emits neutrinos of very high energy up to about 14 million electron volts.